We are continuing our series through the book of Ruth today, and so we're going to be opening chapter 3 of Ruth, and we're going to try to unpack some of that today. I'm really, really excited. I told Pastor Mel when he asked me to fill in for this weekend, I said, man, you gave me the money chapter. I mean, this is the best chapter in the whole book, and I'm so excited that we get to open it together today. I really believe that God is going to speak to our hearts, that there's some incredible things in store for us. And so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to read the entire chapter, and we're going to kind of catch everybody up to where we're at. And then I want to try to unpack that just a little bit and then talk today about how this reveals the great, beautiful depths of God's love for us. And so let's dive right in. Ruth chapter 3, begin reading in verse number 1. If you have a Bible, you can open it up and read along. I'm reading from the ESV, the English Standard Version. If you don't have your Bible with you or you have a different version, it'll be on the screen so you can read along. But let's jump in. Verse number 1 says, then Naomi, her mother-in-law, this is Ruth's mother-in-law, then Naomi, her mother-in-law, said to her, my daughter, should I not seek rest for you that it may be well with you? Is not Boaz our relative, with whose young women you were? See, he is winnowing barley tonight at the threshing floor. Wash, therefore, and anoint yourself, and put on your cloak, and go down to the threshing floor, but do not make yourself known to the man until he has finished eating and drinking. But when he lies down, observe the place where he lies. Then go and uncover his feet and lie down, and he will tell you what to do. And she replied, all that you say, I will do. So she went down to the threshing floor and did just as her mother-in-law had commanded her. And when Boaz... I lost my place. It happens. And when Boaz had eaten and drunk... We're in verse number 7, by the way. And when Boaz had eaten and drunk and his heart was merry, he went to lie down at the end of the heap of grain. Then she came softly and uncovered his feet and lay down. At midnight, the man was startled and turned over, and behold, a woman lay at his feet. He said, who are you? And she answered, I am Ruth, your servant. Spread your wings over your servant, for you are a redeemer. And he said, may you be blessed by the Lord, my daughter. You have made this last kindness greater than the first, in that you have not gone after young men, whether poor or rich. And now, my daughter, do not fear. I will do for you all that you ask, for all my fellow townsmen know that you are a worthy woman. And now it is true that I am a redeemer, yet there is a redeemer nearer than I. Remain tonight, and in the morning, if he will redeem you, good, let him do it. But if he will not, if he is not willing to redeem you, then as the Lord lives, I will redeem you. Lie down until the morning. So she lay at his feet until the morning, but arose before one could recognize another. Rose. Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's celebrate with them today. If you prayed that prayer for the first time today, here's what I'd like to invite you to do. There's some cards in the seat back in front of you. If you would take a few minutes and fill that card out, we just want to be able to be an encouragement and a part of what God's doing in your life and help you to grow in your faith. And so if you could fill that out, or if you're not close to a card, or if you're watching online and you prayed that prayer today, you can text the word salvation to the number 555-888, and then we'll follow up with you from there. I promise we're not gonna bug you or you know, we just want to be a part of what God's doing in your life. We're so excited that you've made the choice and the decision to follow Jesus. And we want you to experience all that life with Jesus has to offer you. We want to help you grow and to learn what it means to follow Jesus and to walk with Him and to be fully surrendered to Him. And so if you could fill out that card or text that salvation to 555-888, we would be honored to walk with you as you start on this journey. And so here's what we're going to do now. This is our custom here at the Summit. If you're not a part of our church or are new here, we like to respond to the word that God has spoken and to what He's done here by singing and giving Him honor and praise together one more time. And so I'd like to ask you to stand, and we're going to sing together. Don't be in a hurry. We'll only be here just a few more minutes. Can we take this time to celebrate the great love of our God and to remember the depths of His great love and the price that He has paid for us, and to just tell Him thank you? Can we do that together? All right, so let's sing together one more time. As we do that, the prayer team is going to be available on either side of the stage. If you have anything that you would like to pray about today, we would love to share your burdens with you and to agree together with you about those needs. So as we sing, you can come and we can pray with you today. Let's rejoice in His great love. Amen. I love you. God bless you.